everybody, thanks for checking out this second video of the Spring Trout series brought to you by Kenzie's Outdoors. And I want to remind all you guys before we start that if you haven't seen the first video in the series, make sure you go check that out right now. We went over spring trout fishing gear, did some shopping at Kenzie's, went over spin fishing setups, fly fishing setups, and much more. So make sure if you haven't seen that, go check it out right now. But anyways, for this video, we're going to be talking about trout fishing opportunities here in Pennsylvania. I'm going to be talking about some spots that I like to go to, some spots I've been to in the past, and some potential spots that I plan on hitting here this spring. But before I get into all that, I want you guys to go down to the comments below this video and give me some suggestions. Where do you guys want to see me trout fish this spring? Head on down to the comments, let me know what you think, give me some suggestions, and I'll definitely take them into consideration either for during this series or maybe later on this spring or even into next year. If you're a trout fisherman and you live here in Pennsylvania, you should feel very fortunate for the amount of opportunities that we have right here around us. Pennsylvania is actually considered by many people to be one of the best states in the whole eastern United States to fish for trout. There's people that come from hours and hours away to fish Pennsylvania. So I don't know about you guys, but I am definitely very thankful for the amount of opportunities that we have here in Pennsylvania to catch trout. So the first thing I want to do here is I want to go online with you guys on the computer, and I'm going to show you some of the resources that I use for finding trout streams to fish in Pennsylvania, and more specifically in my area or in a certain area of the state that I want to go to. So we're going to hop over here onto the computer, and I'm going to show you some of the links and maps that I like to use on the Pennsylvania Fish and Boat Commission website. All right, so we're here on the homepage of the Pennsylvania Fish and Boat Commission website. I'm going to go over here up to the top on the tab where it says fish. Scroll down here to trout, click on that, and then we're going to scroll down here to where it says trout water classifications, click on that, and then if you scroll down here to the third one where it says stocked trout waters, click on that. This gives you a map of Pennsylvania and all six regions, so you can click on whichever region you want to go to. And this is going to give you a county by county breakdown and all the stocked trout waters within each of those counties. So I clicked on Southeast. So you can see here, it gives you a list of all the creeks within that county. Berks County, you got a whole long list of creeks. Scroll down here, Lancaster County, you got Conowingo Creek, Big Beaver Creek, Octorara Creek, Little Cocalico Creek. We'll go back here, click on South Central. You can see Dauphin County. We got Clark Creek. I've fished that one before. That's a good one. Monada Creek. I've been there. You got Stony Creek. That's another good one. Go down here. You see we got Lebanon County. Quitafilla Creek, aka the Quitty. That's another good one. You got part of the Tulpehocken up in Lebanon. You got a whole long list of creeks here in York County. Yellow Breaches, that's a real good one. That touches into York County. The other part of the Yellow Breaches is up here in Cumberland County. And a lot of good trout streams on here. So this is a resource that I use all the time. Of course, I have plenty of creeks that I've been to in the past that I already know about that I like to hit, but this is a great way to check out new streams and find new places to go. I always like that about trout fishing, trying out a new creek for the first time, and this is a great way to do it. You can click here, North Central PA. I mean, there's tons of creeks up there that really aren't all that far of a drive away from down here in Lancaster where I live. So now the next thing I want to show you is another resource I use. So we're back here. Let's go back here to the homepage. So we're going to do the same thing. Go down, click on fish, go down here to trout. And then we're going to scroll down here to the interactive map section and click on county guide. And this is going to, again, give us a whole map of Pennsylvania and every county. And over here on the left, you can click these layers. And if you clicked stocked trout streams, it's going to highlight in orange every single stocked trout stream in all of Pennsylvania. So you can literally zoom into any area you want. So let's go in here to our area. You can see all the stocked trout streams highlighted. So you can zoom in on all these, and you can see there's Hammer Creek here in Lancaster County. We got Little Chickies Creek. That one's real local to Kinsey's. And then over here, you can play around with all these different layers. Let's unclick stocked trout streams. You can click on stocked trout lakes. That's going to give you a pin of every single trout lake that is stocked in Pennsylvania. That's another thing that we're going to hopefully be trying in this series is fishing a stillwater lake for trout. And up here, this is one of the lakes we like to fish for that sometimes, Stover's Dam up in Lebanon. And then another thing, if you guys don't know about it, is the stocking schedule. So if you go here to fish, go down to stocking schedules. This is huge. I'm always checking the stocking schedule, seeing when all my favorite creeks are getting stocked so that I can go hit those soon after they get stocked. So you go up here, you can select any county you want. So let's just, for this sake, let's just click on Lancaster County. And you get down here, you just hit go. You can put in your date range up there. And this is going to give you every single creek within that county that is stocked and the date that it's going to be stocked and with what fish it's going to be stocked with. Brooks, brown rainbows, and golden rainbows. And then the other thing is it gives you the upper and lower limits. So you can click on these and that's going to give you a pin on a map of the upper limit of that stocked section. And then if I click on that, that would give me the lower limit. So a lot of these creeks are divided into multiple sections. For example, Hammer Creek right here, divided into a few different sections, but all these sections are stocked. So that's another resource that I'm using constantly, trying to plan out my trout fishing trips in line with those stocking schedules, trying to hit them sometime relatively soon after they're stocked. So a couple of my favorite creeks to fish here in my area are the Tulpehocken Creek in Berks County and then the Yellow Breeches Creek over in York and Cumberland County. Those are two of my favorite trout streams. I fish at both of those quite a bit and can pretty much almost guarantee that I'll be at those creeks several times here during the spring. Both of those streams have sections that are designated for artificial or fly fishermen only, and then areas that you are allowed to spin fish in with live bait. So I'll probably be utilizing both of those sections on each of those creeks doing spin fishing and fly fishing. So here's a map of some of the parking spots on the top part of the Tulpehocken Creek. Up here at the top, the Tulpehocken is the flows of the creek are regulated by the Blue Marsh Dam up here. So before you go out fishing on the Tulpehocken, you want to make sure you go online and check the water levels. And overall, great access. You can see several spots to get to the creek at. So overall, the Tulpehocken is very nice. The wading on the Tully is very easy compared to other trout streams that would be this size. So I like going there a lot. It's easy access. You don't really ever have to walk too far to get to the creek. It does get hit with a little bit of pressure because it is a fairly popular creek. Another thing about this top section of the Tulpehocken is that it's called a Keystone Select Area. And what that means is the Fish and Boat Commission stocks a lot of big fish in those sections that they call Keystone Select. So you can go here to the Tully and have a chance to really hook into a monster trout. So for fly fishing, some of the flies that we like to use on the Tully are for sure midges. We use those pretty much any time throughout the spring. Those are a really big one. And then you got sulfurs, blue-winged olives, and of course you got all your caddis. Your typical wet flies, your basic nymphs like pheasant tails and hare's ear are always gonna work real well. And then your streamers, woolly buggers, San Juan worms and squirmy worms. I catch fish on those all the time at the Tully. I love drifting those things. So the Yellow Breeches is another one of my favorites. Me and my friends like to go to that creek several times throughout the spring. We love the fly fish there. The Yellow Breeches is absolutely loaded with trout. You get there, you do some exploring, find your favorite holes, your favorite sections of creek to fish, find those parking spots that are closest to that, and you're going to learn that creek pretty quick if you get out there and explore it. So those are two of my favorite creeks, but really other than those, I am completely open to where I can trout fish. I'm going to use those resources quite a bit. I do that every year. The ones I was showing you guys earlier, the maps and the lists of all the creeks within each county, I'm going to go on there and just pick new creeks to go to at certain times during the spring because I like exploring new places and because there's so many options here in our area of Pennsylvania. I want to thank you all for watching this second video of the Kinsey Spring Trout Series. I hope you found it helpful and entertaining. Don't forget, like I said earlier, go down to the comments below the video and give me some suggestions on where you would like to see me fish for trout this spring. I hope all you folks have a great fishing season. Once again, thank you for watching, and we will see you guys on the next video.